Nice. Ah, it's Smashville, alright. So there's no button check going into it right now. Oh, Sonic's with an aggressive dash attack. Oh, okay. Diddy Kong, Scythe throwing out those really strong and quick hitboxes from Fair and Bear to just stack up a lot of damage. Good punishing the... waiting for the side B and punishing it.
Oh, test, test, yeah. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, for a rather spontaneous co-commentator. Hi, I'm Buralol, yeah. And we are in winner's quarters, Scythe against Sonix.
So, actually not really looking too good for Sonix right now. Diddy using a lot of his prominent areas to stack up the damage, yeah.
Mm. I think the difficulty in this matchup lies in the fact that Diddy Kong controls the ground game with his banana and stops any spin attack approaches or spin dash approaches, and that's really troublesome for Sonic.
Yeah,
granted that he cannot really approach well from the air too.
Yeah. Sonic has to be really creative when trying to even come near Diddy Kong. Yeah, that's
it. Ooh, that was really nice confirm.
Yeah.
I think Diddy Kong is a character that is really like solid. I mean, he has a lot of consistency built in with his down tilt and banana play.
Like, he doesn't have anything crazy jank-like, but he has those solid things that can really help him win matchups.
The only janking maybe is barrels?
Yeah, those are... we don't talk about those.
But that is really smart from Scythe, pulling out the banana, knowing the platform is there, so that if he ever needs one, if he can pull one out.
Ah, like now? Okay. Stuck a shield, got grabbed. This is a good chance for Sonic to do something, maybe. No chance taken. Yeah, throwing out those fares because it's so much range. Yeah.
Nice anti, yeah. That's where Sonic really struggles. He actually cannot approach, and Diddy has really nice moves to anti-air him.
Yeah, up to being a really quick option.
Interesting also that Sonic is that far in the tournament, being an up-and-coming player.
Yeah, really good too, really good player. But maybe... he's still not out yet, there's always a chance.
He still definitely has the mountain to climb. It's really difficult getting past Diddy Kong's defense.
Yeah. Diddy Kong character with the fair, if he auto cancels this correctly, it's really hard to bypass that.
Yeah, that's true. A lot of characters struggling against that too.
Yeah.
But unless you have a sword, you are really screwed.
Yeah, and even then, like, if you're tall, you just get hit by the fairy regardless, and it's really tough.
Nice DI mixer.
Oh, yeah, crisp. Yeah.
He was DI-ing out to not get hit by the up smash.
But then he just fared him and then he died. So
that's really interesting that even his down tilt, it's a frame 4 confirm and you're always likely to DI it away. Because even though it's frame 4, you always expect it.
Yeah, that's true.
And the mix-up was really well by Scythe to mix him up there.
Yeah, that's true. It really shows that he knows his character. So it's going to be Battlefield, okay. Interesting, because I'm not sure if Sonic is that good on the triplets. But maybe he wants to live longer to not get killed by a down tilt up smash.
Maybe.
Might be a reason.
It's true. But Sonic himself is really a character that mostly kills vertically.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure why he picked Battlefield. Maybe he thinks that he has the advantage on triplets with his superior movement and faster aerials.
Yeah.
Also that when Scythe pulls a banana, it lands on the platform, so he doesn't have immediate access to it.
Yeah.
As you can see right there.
Oh, he tried to spring right. Spring right in.
Spring right in 2K17.
Nah, that's a meme.
Really interesting that even some people, some Sonics try to mix it up like as a mix-up, but even then you can just hold away and you will not get it.
If you hold away, you're safe, most likely. If Sonics had the advantage, he could just camp the platforms, but because Diddy doesn't have a lot of platform pressure, I think. But now he's like 70% behind, and this Sonic has to find a way to go in. Okay, there's an offstage situation. This is one of Diddy Kong's weaker points.
True.
Yeah. Okay, nothing.
Interesting.
So hard to find an opening for Sonic. Ah, there he goes.
It's true.
He jumped over the banana with the first part of the side B. Maybe that could help.
Yeah, if you spin charge and he does a little hop, and this little hop is actually invincible, so you can actually also parry through attacks.
That's true. That's
a really strong aspect of his spin dashes. If you have seen like a few games from Sonic's against Schliga, you always used his side B invincibility to get through Shadow Ball.
Yeah,
that was a nice game.
The thing is, Diddy Kong is not going to Cypher is not going to land on you with aerials, so you have to come to him. So I don't know if that's really helpful at the moment. Also, he got him with the side B spike or whatever that was at the offstage. That was really interesting.
Ooh, nice confirm. Forward to back air.
Yeah. Oh, the spring could be a. If he times it better, he might.
Yeah, that's actually a legitimate gimping tool. The problem is that Diddy Kong can easily play around it.
Yeah.
But there are situations where like top Sonics manage to gimp Diddy Kongs like that.
Yeah. If this character has a weakness, that's the barrel part. This is his biggest weakness.
Yeah, his recovery probably.
Yeah. But other than that, such solid control with the banana, man.
Yeah. I think that's also like a good part of Scythe. Like, I mean, he played Brawl too, and he was also Diddy Kong main in Brawl, and Diddy Kong's item game was way more prominent in Brawl.
Oh yeah, having two banana plants.
Yeah, and they lasted for eternity.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus. Didn't play that competitively, but sounds interesting. Okay.
Wow, nice option coverage. The way he reverses banana.
Also,
the peanut popgun to cover basically any options.
Yeah.
Force him to wait out his invincibility and then go for a mix up or trump.
Yeah. He couldn't even jump and land on the platform because of the banana.
Yeah.
Okay. Really hard to deal with the banana if you don't have a tool to remove that instantly. Oh, it was a jab one for. Oh, okay.
Well, even though Diddy Kong has like pseudo kill throws, like with his F throw, back throw, they don't start killing unless you have like 180 or something center stage, and even at the ledge, you actually need a lot of percent.
Yeah,
even
but
even with full rage.
Sonic, on the other hand, even though his back throw got nerfed, it's still better than as a kill throw.
That's true. I mean, you still see a consistent use of it as a kill throw.
Yeah.
Rather than like positional throw.
Oh, that was the
really
same.
Bad, yeah.
Yeah, that was the same mix up again. But he lived because Battlefield.
I mean, he still fell for it, but he just had luck that
the
side blast zones are just really wide on Battlefield.
Oh.
Oh, nice catch.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's really interesting that with Sonic, a lot of the. How can I say it? Yeah, a lot of the games tend to be slower paced and more neutral heavy than other.
We can see already like 1 minute 20 seconds.
Yeah. Ooh, interesting.
So much of Diddy Kong. I wanted to say up to now. Yeah, that's he was at a percent where everything killed, so almost.
That's true.
Hard to kill.
But
hard
really,
to say
really, that. Really, kudos to Sonic that he managed to live that long.
Yeah.
Especially against Diddy Kong. I mean, you could say, alright, Diddy Kong needs his grab or really a confirm to kill.
Yeah.
But he really. If you played well around Scythe's normals that lead into these kind of
That's true.
Confirms, yeah.
So let's see. Sonic is. I don't think he's gonna. He has some other characters like a Pit, but I wouldn't advise for it. I would say he should stay Sonic most likely.
Yeah, I mean, always play your best character. There is, unless you are not confident in your secondary, there's, in my opinion, not a real reason to play it.
Yeah, confidence in your character is the most important thing.
True.
So
unless there are, of course, matchups where you could go for a secondary, but if you don't have one.
Gandalf and Bayonetta, man. That's not a good matchup. Okay. So Town City. Actually, the second game, he picked Battlefield probably because he could live longer vertically, but Town City has, I think it's the lowest?
It has the lowest ceiling.
Yeah, so that's a really interesting contrast. Maybe saying, I should maybe try to get the vertical kills and not him, because I don't really I think he only died once this set through down tilt up smash.
This may be true.
Yeah,
he's probably confident in his own skill to kill him vertically. Then he's afraid of Diddy Kong.
Yeah.
And that's sometimes the things you need, the aspects. I mean, being confident even though you are behind, giving your opponent actually a good stage. But you profit off it as well, of course.
Yeah.
Oh, interesting confirm.
Ah, the neutral B is a move, like, if you land on the ground with it, it's so damn laggy, man.
Yeah, it's really punishable.
Yeah.
I think Sonic's get away with it way too much.
Yeah, Sonic is a character that's way riskier than he... Oh my god, oh no, this is the third time.
130%. Oh, and no. The interesting part is also that the side blast zones from Tournament City are really close to the ledges.
Yeah.
So you see horizontal kills way more frequently than you would see on any other stage. Especially ledge kills happen a lot on Tournament City.
Oh, interesting reversal. Couldn't combo off the soft nair. Really hard. What should Sonic do in this matchup to try to open him up? What should he do? Okay. Oh, but it's much closer than it was before. Oh, yes. He actually got him. Damn, that's really good. Another BMBs. Managing to get two backers.
So, Sonic's possibly on his last winner's stock.
Yeah, tournament winner's point.
Nice, he needs these kind of openings.
Yeah.
A spin dash from a bad landing from Sives, and then just punish it.
That's true. Sonic is a character that can wait out because of speed. Wait for the opportunity.
I mean, he has no difficulty closing gaps.
Yeah, no at all.
And that's the reason why he's a top tier character, because he has the possibility to camp out effectively every character, and then close gaps even if they try to camp you out.
Yeah.
He lacks though in kill power, I would say. Like, most of his confirms kill really late, or they confirm really late. Or else you just need to raw F smash or up smash.
Yeah,
but those are rare.
Yeah.
Never mind!
And the other stuff like spring ride or I don't know, like spin dash into fair off stage. Those are more like, I wouldn't say gimmicks, but they have niche uses.
That's true.
Yeah, banana.
I mean, he's slowly coming back. But Scythe definitely has constant pressure.
Yeah. I think he's at a percent rate where a down tilt up smash will kill. Especially at Tournament City, that's like guaranteed.
Definitely.
Yeah, that's
death.
It, as we said. Yep. Valiant effort, but it wasn't enough, sadly.
The games, even though it was a 3-0, the games were actually really close.
Yeah.
Well, not in the sense of that both were at last stock, last hit. But Sonic was able to put up a fight.
Yeah, definitely. Shows that he can do stuff. He's up and newcoming, and he will... Looking forward to a future. Okay, so most likely it will be Quick or not?
Yeah, we will have Quick against Woozy.